kill Abel. Unbalanced land trying to keep the people stable. The way I feel, I might it all up. The way you feel, you might do it for the buck. All black, born to be a rebel. After this, I might go in water down the devil. Listen to everything around me, I can't see. You picked a dozen roses and left them in Galilee rolling thunder. Don't hear my cry, don't let alibis pass you by. Finally starting to realize, never give up and coerce. I can't watch TV, it's all a lot. Time to try and go ahead and fly. Everybody want a straight answer, but media keep us blind. A good heart is not hard to find. Why do people try to define infrastructure? I don't got time. Infrastructure, I don't got time. I could it's all too. We're talking about your brother protecting the sons and daughters from political mislaughter.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
From the site that many call the loudest in the NFL, we are inside Arrowhead Stadium here in Kansas City. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle with the Denver Broncos. Here's the kicker, Harrison Butker, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Arrowhead. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
Now a first carry for Melvin Gordon. And they're able to get this one across the 35. First down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14.
A gain of 14.
This is Gordon.
First down.
And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5.
Taken down.
After the pickup of 5, here's second and 5.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up second and 5.
Lock gonna hand it off here to Gordon. And he'll go down right around the 47 this time.
The tackle made at the 47-yard line. A 5-yard gain on the play.
Now Gordon on first down. And he'll take it across the 50 and into Chief territory.
Bronco ball carrier.
It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up second down.
49-yard line.
Down to the air. Rock. Flushed out right. 8 yards that time. Able to take off, and the result is a first down.
Pickup. First down, Bronco.
Now Gordon. And the lane closes up quickly as he'll get about 3 down to the 38. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7.
It's a pickup of 3.
Fakes the give to Gordon. Now here's Locke to throw. They'll roll him out right. He'll try and run it. It's been a 7-play opening drive, and this is 3rd and short.
It's a gain of 7.
They'll try and run it. Here's Gordon. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. The Bronco first down there, 12 yards on the play. Into the red zone, it's Locke. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
First and goal, Denver.
Throwing now is Locke. Hammering for the goal line. He loses the football. And the offense is able to pounce on it inside the 5-yard line. This has been a long drive. You know that defense, they're craving to get off the field. They were able to force it free but couldn't recover it.
Yeah, and on the offensive side of the ledger, they were thinking about how do we punctuate this drive.
And the pass is caught. Touchdown, Denver. Jerry Jeudy.
Touchdown, Denver.
The 3-yard touchdown pass. And the Broncos take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. And he's got it. 7-0 Broncos.
Makes the score. Broncos 7. Chiefs nothing.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
Mahomes will lead the Chiefs up first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. He'll throw from the gun.
A
A hit as he throws there, incomplete. He was looking for his tight end, Kelsey, but it'll be second down.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tucker roll that they can fall back on anymore.
Now a pass that's taken in by Hill. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 12 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Mahomes going to throw. He'll find his running back, Edwards-Helaire. And he'll be out of bounds after getting this one across the 40.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
45. Throwing again on second down. Mahomes. And this is caught at the 20.
What's he doing
and
on that
ball? All the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. Tyreek Hill. 57 yards, and the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Well, that was the fly route for a touchdown, and since he caught that one and scored it, I got to tell the story. Before the game, we were standing there. He was running deep routes, dropped one. It bounced up and just hit me right in the gut. I said, come on, man, but there was no drop.
Yeah, you okay now?
I'm good.
All right, good. We got the ice pack up here. You're just fine. What I loved about it was the subtlety of the route, because everyone knows he's fast. They're going to play him for that route first and foremost. But sometimes it's a head fake, it's varying your speed off the line of scrimmage, it's giving the defensive back different angles to think about. Is he going inside? Is he going outside? And then, as you noted, he just took off past him. Oops, there he goes again.
Now Locke, he lost the football, it's out. And it's picked up by the Chiefs. So they take over not only in enemy territory, but in the red zone at the 16-yard line.
By the defense.
So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Now after the fumble recovery, it's Mahomes. And it's incomplete.
Mahomes pass, thrown to the sideline and incomplete. Brings up second and 10.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. From the gun, it's Mahomes. And his throw is incomplete. Travis Kelce, the Pro Bowl tight end, the intended target. And it's third down. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. Throwing is Mahomes on third. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Will Parks. And he will be brought down, but he's got the interception on a final play of this first quarter. These two teams all tied after one.
To seven.
Locke and the Broncos going to come up first and 10 at their own 17-yard line. He'll hand this one off to Gordon, and he'll get this up to the 30-yard line. Give him 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also give him a first down.
Gain of 13 yards.
They run it here with Gordon. First down. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
He's brought down at the 37-yard line. A 6-yard pickup brings up second and
Gordon. And he'll take this one for about 4 up to the 40.
On the carry. Anthony Hitchens brought him down. That's a gain of 4.
Now a 10th carry for Melvin Gordon. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. Two first downs have him up to the 41 now for first and 10.
First down, Denver.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And this will set them up nicely deep down in KC territory. A big change in field position there. That's 40 yards on the catch and run.
First down, Broncos.
Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards.
When you lose that kind of yardage on a pass play, you often expect it to be a sack. But that wasn't the case there. They completed the pass. probably would have been better off just dropping the football and making an incompletion as opposed to catching it and losing that kind of yardage.
Now a pass dumped off to his running back. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Jerry Jeudy. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Broncos have taken the lead. And it's up and good.
Makes the score, Broncos 14, Chiefs.
After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And the interception thrown in the red zone last time. We'll see if they can rebound.
I just have to think the last thing he said is that
a big seam, and he might go all the way. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. DeMarcus Robinson, 75 yards. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And we've got a good one brewing. We're all knotted up at 14.
That ties the game at 14.
This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20.
At their own 20-yard line.
Rocking the Broncos, going to come up first and 10 at the 20. They'll start the drive with a run by Gordon. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards.
19 yards. And the Broncos first down.
A reminder coming up here at halftime. We'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. The Mississippi State man, Chris Jones, with a sack there.
So this has been a lot like a tennis match, hasn't it? Back and forth. Both of these offenses happened their way so far, so maybe the question isn't who's going to score the most points in this game? Maybe it's who's going to get some stops.
Yeah, absolutely. And that sack, finally a first step in the right direction for a stop. Locke going to try and throw on third down. He's got a man. It's Sutton. That's complete. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Locke and Sutton on the connection there for a Denver first down. On the slant, completes to Sutton. And he will have a first down here as they get into field goal range as well, down at the 17-yard line. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first. He was looking to get it to Phillip Lindsay there. And now it's second down.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. To throw again. Lock. He dumps it underneath here to Lindsay. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Here's the seventh play of this drive. This is third and four. Again, they'll throw with Lock into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off inside the 10. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Intercepted. The Chiefs take over first and 10 at their own 38-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And last time, the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up, whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook. One play drive is exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was fairly easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
And we'll see if it's that easy here. They'll contain him to just four. Second down.
It's now second and six.
Shotgun snap to Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left. He was looking for Tyreek Hill that time. And it's third down.
6 yards to go.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. Final shot before the half for Mahomes. And going deep for Hill. Got a man. It's caught
time, baby.
Inside the 10. And he's in for the touchdown on the final play of the first half. The prayer is answered.
How did they get that done?
So they grabbed the lead just before half with a clock reading 0-0-0.
How about snatching things right at the end and grabbing a little bit of control? What a great way to go into the locker room. It's similar to a boxer flurrying in the last 30 seconds of a round and stealing the round. Great job.
Ready for the start of the third quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. Fielded near the back of the end zone. And we will not see a return to start the half as this will be a touchback. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
DeMarcus Robinson, the intended target on that one. And that'll bring up second down. To throw, it's Mahomes. Over the middle, complete. That's Sherman. And now a fumble. The ball's out. It's picked up by the Broncos. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. Obviously, you got to hold on to the football, but I've got to give credit to the defense there. Good job of knocking it free.
Yeah, because a lot of the time we just blame the offensive players for not taking care of it. How about the effort of the defensive players knowing that guys are going to, and if they're good, anticipate the contact coming and try and cover up the football, and they still find ways to knock it free.
That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down. He's going to be sacked back at the 23-yard line. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
Block on target there to Fant, the tight end. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Block on target to Fant for a Bronco first down. Block working out of the gun. His pass caught at the 4. And he is out of bounds here. A gain of 9 there. Sets up second and goal.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective.
And he is into the end zone for a Denver touchdown. Strong running from Melvin Gordon as he scores from a yard out. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game. He's got it, and we're all tied at 21.
That ties the game at 21 apiece.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. Fielded near the back of the end zone, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive, and they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in cap.
Oh, this is intercepted, intended for Hill. A.J. Boye with a pick. And they will finally get him, but not until he's all the way down inside the 15-yard line.
By the Broncos.